I can start. Donc, bonjour à toutes et bonjour à tous. Nous vous remercions pour votre présence. Avant de commencer, nous voudrions partager avec vous quelques informations concernant la manière d'interagir durant le webinaire. Premièrement, aujourd'hui, nous parlerons principalement en français et une traduction en anglais vous sera proposée. Si vous n'êtes pas à l'aise avec cela, il n'y a aucun problème. Nous déposerons l'enregistrement du webinaire sur YouTube. En tant qu'étudiants en muséologie, nous nous sommes présentés bénévolement et nous ne sommes pas des professionnels de la traduction. Nous sommes sûrs que vous comprendrez si nous commettons quelques erreurs. Deuxièmement, nous vous proposons d'écouter les interventions jusqu'à leur fin et ensuite vous disposerez d'un temps de questions et réponses. Si vous désirez poser une question ou faire une remarque, s'il vous plaît, écrivez votre nom dans le chat. Nous vous contacterons à la fin des interventions et vous pourrez allumer votre micro et votre webcam afin d'interagir. Nous essayerons de vous aider avec la traduction du mieux que nous pouvons. S'il vous est possible de parler en anglais ou en français, cela nous sera d'une grande aide. Troisièmement, veuillez garder votre micro éteint durant le webinaire. Enfin, nous allons enregistrer ce webinaire afin de le stocker sur YouTube. S'il vous plaît, si vous n'êtes pas à l'aise avec l'enregistrement, vous avez le choix de regarder ce webinaire avec des sous-titres à partir de fin avril sur YouTube. Si vous avez des questions sur l'organisation ou un problème technique, n'hésitez pas à nous contacter via le chat ou par le mail BabbleTower. Nous vous remercions pour votre attention et nous vous souhaitons un bon webinaire. Good morning, everybody. Thank you for being here. Before starting, we would like to share with you some information on who to interact during the webinar. First, today we will talk mainly in French with translation in English. If you don't feel comfortable with that, don't worry. We will upload the registration of the webinar on YouTube. As students in museology, we are volunteers and we are not professional translators. We are sure you will understand if we make some mistakes. Second, you will hear the intervention and at the end, there will be time for questions and answers. If you want to ask a question or make a comment, please write your name in the chat. At the end of the intervention, and you will be able to open your microphone and the webcam in order to interact. We'll try to help with the translation at the best, but if you can speak English or French, that will be help us a lot. Third, please silence your microphone during the webinar. Finally, we are going to record this webinar in order to store it on YouTube. Please, if you don't feel comfortable, you have the option to watch the webinar by YouTube with subtitles by the end of April. If you have any question about the organization or a technical problem, don't hesitate to contact us via chat or the BabbleTower email. Thank you and enjoy it.
Bonjour à tous et à toutes. Good morning for everybody. I will speak in French, but I have a student of the organization that will put translation in the chat. I only will try to see if she has already access to the chat. It's okay, Megan?
Hello. No, I'm sorry. I still can access to the chat. So I think that Pauline will send the translation for me. Okay. I'm really sorry for this issue.
Okay, thank you very much.
Okay. There is a hand that has been raised by Mina Red.
Mina Red, do you have a problem to...
Probably was just a trial.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Okay. I will start in French. Nous sommes heureuses et heureuses de vous recevoir dans la série de webinars Tour de Babel, Jean de Musée en dialogue. Ces webinars résultent de la mission de recherche de Gilles Papalardo comme chercheuse invitée dans le service de muséologie de l'Université de Liège entre février et avril. Gilles Papalardo est maître de conférences et chercheuse en urbanisme et aménagement du territoire à l'Université de Catane en Sicile. Sa mission est parrainée avec une bourse du Fonds social européen dans le cadre du programme Attraction et mobilité internationale des chercheurs. C'est un homme très important du monde des musées et notamment des écomusées et musées communautaires, Hugues de Varine, ancien directeur du Conseil international des musées, qui nous a mis en contact. Il a suggéré à Gilles Papalardo réaliser une étape de ses recherches au service de muséologie de l'Université de Liège. Dans la vallée de la rivière de Cimetto, en Sicile, elle réalise depuis 10 ans une recherche-action impliquée dans l'implantation d'un écomusée. Elle souhaite explorer les connexions entre ce qui se passe dans la vallée de Cimetto et dans d'autres expériences similaires dans un ou autre aspect partout dans le monde. Il ne s'agit pas seulement de discuter et de connaître des écomusées et des musées communautaires, mais d'une façon plus large, d'étudier les relations entre les gens d'un territoire, son patrimoine et les paysages, le développement local et les approches sociales de la muséologie. Hugues de Varine, comme certains de vous, connaît l'existence d'un projet de recherche et d'un cours, un séminaire de muséologie autour des musées et muséologie en sujet, que j'expliquerai mieux la semaine prochaine. C'est autour des intérêts de recherche de Gilles Papalardo et de ses projets de recherche et du cours de séminaire de muséologie, les musées et muséologie en sujet, que je donne les vendredis le matin, que cette série a commencé à être imaginée. Nous avons prévu au départ quelques sessions ouvertes au public l'après-midi en anglais, car il y a des invités de l'Amérique du Nord et du Sud. Finalement, nous avons décidé d'ouvrir toutes les séances au public, mais sans avoir prévu une traduction professionnelle. Les étudiants se sont proposés, en tant que bénévoles, à vous aider avec traduction des questions et à préparer des sous-titres pour les vidéos qui seront mises sur YouTube pour la fin d'avril. Donc, si vous n'êtes pas confortable avec l'horaire ou la langue, n'hésitez pas à attendre pour assister aux enregistrements. Nous comptons avec votre compréhension. Je voudrais remercier les collègues qui participent avec moi du comité scientifique de la série, Giuse Papalardo et Martina Barcelloni Corte, de la Faculté d'Architecture de l'Université de Liège, collègues de l'Unité de Recherche Art, Archéologie et Patrimoine. Je remercie aussi les groupes d'étudiantes, des masters et des doctorants qui forment le comité d'organisation de la série et qui continuent à recevoir de nouvelles adhésions. Obé Albitar, Pauline Duré, Julia Gulli, Megan Fassin, Alix Nissen, Edouard Nzoyera, Océane Mest, Florian Paquet, Camille Hoff-Sumer et Léa Di Francesco. Nous sommes très heureuses et fiers d'avoir pu réunir dans ce programme des personnes de plusieurs pays, continents, des différentes insertions institutionnelles et expériences qui vont pouvoir contribuer avec ces réflexions et points de vue très divers. Merci à tous les invités qui ont accepté d'intervenir dans cette série de webinaires. À ce moment, nous avons 71 inscrits de 16 pays, tels que le Portugal, Allemagne, Pays-Bas, Mozambique, Chili, Mexique, Lebanon, entre autres, et bien sûr plusieurs Belges, Italiens et Brésiliens. Parmi les présents, nous comptons aussi, entre autres, avec le président du Conseil international des musées, Alberto Garlandini. Un tout grand merci. Le projet a commencé sans toutes ses ambitions et est devenu plus important, mais toujours dans un esprit d'expérimentation, de collaboration et d'amitié qui marque les muséologies appelées ici d'insurgés. La nouvelle muséologie, la muséologie sociale, la sociomuséologie, la muséologie communautaire, l'écomuséologie et beaucoup d'autres. Ces muséologies au pluriel qui n'hésitent pas à se définir comme indisciplinées et affectées. Le but de cette série est donc de creuser plusieurs intersections. On passe des intersections entre paysage et patrimoine, ouvrant la discussion vers divers échanges transnationaux et transdisciplinaires. L'idée du titre est liée à l'opportunité d'explorer différentes langues, domaines et jargons impliqués dans les domaines des musées, de leurs relations avec les gens, leur territoire, le développement local et la muséologie. La grande question derrière ces voyages est de savoir comment ces gens s'identifient aux signes tangibles et intangibles de leur passé afin de planifier un avenir plus juste et inclusif en période de transition écologique et de changements sociétaux. Bienvenue. Donc, je passe la parole maintenant à Giuse Pappalardo qui donnera suite au programme. Merci.
Thank you. Okay. Can you see my screen?
Yes.
Okay. Welcome to everybody and thank you for being here at the first webinar of this series. And as Professor Duarte has just anticipated, my name is Giuse Pappalardo and I am a lecturer and a researcher of urban and regional planning at the University of Catania in Sicily. A region of southern Italy. I'm here with Guido Carruba, who is a young student interested in the topic that we are discussing today, which is the concept and the practice of eco-museums. And he comes from the same hometown of mine, which is Catania. He will translate in French what I say in English. Thank you, Guido, for that. And I will also offer some comments from the perspective of a young student, like some of you that are attending the webinar today.
Bonjour à toutes et à tous, et merci d'être ici pour le premier webinaire de cette série. Comme la prof Duarte vient d'anticiper, je m'appelle Giuse Pappalardo, je suis maître de la conférence des chercheurs en urbanisme à l'Université de Catane en Sicile, une région du sud de l'Italie. Moi, je suis Guido Carruba et je serai le traducteur pour aujourd'hui. Je voudrais m'excuser par avance pour mon français, ma prononciation pas parfaite. Je suis un étudiant en ingénierie passionné par les thèmes environnementaux qui collabore à ce projet écomuséal à Catane.
Also today we are honored to host Giuseppe Reina that has been and still is one of the most active advocates of ecomuseums in Italy. He has dedicated his doctoral research to the cause, earning a PhD in 2012, and he pushed for the making and the approval of the Sicilian regional law on ecomuseums in 2014. Now he's one of the organizers of the Italian network of ecomuseums. He will give us an introduction on ecomuseum with a specific focus on how they are framed in the Italian debate. Then I'll give a practical example of what Giuseppe will discuss, telling you the story of an ecomuseal process in Sicily, which is the one of the Simeto River community. Giuseppe and I are working together on the current phases of this process, which we think can offer some food for thoughts and open some reflections for our journey up to the Babel Tower.
De plus, nous avons l'honneur d'accueillir aujourd'hui Giuseppe Reina, qui a été et il est toujours l'un des défenseurs les plus actifs des écomusées en Italie. Il a consacré sa recherche doctorale à cette cause, obtenant un doctorat en 2012 et il a pressionné pour la création et l'approbation de la loi régionale sicilienne sur les écomusées en 2014. Aujourd'hui, il est un des organisateurs du réseau italien des écomusées. Il nous présentera les écomusées en mettant l'accent sur la façon dont ils sont encadrés dans les débats italiens. Ensuite, je donnerai un exemple pratique de ce dont Giuseppe va parler en vous racontant l'histoire d'un procès écomuséal en Sicile, qui est celui de la communauté du fleuve Simeto. Giuseppe et moi travaillons ensemble sur les phases actuelles de ce procès qui, nous pensons, peut nous faire penser et ouvrir réflexion pour notre voyage jusqu'à la tour de Babel.
Before starting, let me add a few words about the reasons behind this series. Thanks to the European funded project, which is specific for southern regions such as Sicily, where local development is lagging behind, I'm virtually here at the Department of Science History, University of Liegi, as visiting researcher. I wish I could have been there physically, and I hope I will be able to do that in the upcoming months if conditions related with the pandemic crisis ameliorate and fortunately we can see encouraging signals.
Avant de commencer, permettez-moi d'ajouter quelques mots sur les raisons de cette série. Grâce à un projet financé par l'Union européenne qui est spécifique pour les régions méridionales comme la Sicile où le développement local est en retard, je suis virtuellement ici au département des sciences historiques en tant que chercheur invité. J'aurais aimé pouvoir être là physiquement et j'espère pouvoir le faire dans les prochains mois si les conditions liées à la crise pandémique s'améliorent. Heureusement, nous pouvons voir des signaux encourageants.
I'm glad I've started a collaboration with Martina Manuelina Duarte, Martina Barcelloni Corte, and the research group, which I really want to thank for having welcomed me, although in this long distance asset. But please let me also express my gratitude to Devarin, because he has been the one who suggested to create and to reinforce international connections, not only among scholars, but also among activists, professionals, people, among museum people. What I think that all these people have in common, despite the different approaches and nuances, is a dedicated work aimed at raising awareness about the past in order to nurture local development path from a community-based perspective, toward the goal of more just, inclusive, and democratic societies. But this is also what we are going to explore and discover with this series.
Je suis heureuse d'une collaboration avec Manuelina Duarte, Martelina Barcelloni Corte et le groupe de recherche, que je tiens vraiment à remercier de m'avoir accueilli, bien que de cette façon à distance. Mais, s'il vous plaît, permettez-moi aussi d'exprimer ma gratitude à Hugues de Varin, celui qui a suggéré de créer et renforcer les liens internationaux, pas seulement entre les universités, mais aussi entre les militants, les professionnels et les gens du musée. Je pense que tous ces peuples ont en commun, malgré des approches différentes, un travail dédié à sensibiliser sur le passé, afin d'offrir des voies de développement local, dans une perspective communautaire vers l'objectif d'une société plus juste, inclusive et démocratique. Mais c'est aussi ce que nous allons explorer et découvrir dans ces rencontres.
And so here we are, starting a webinar series which aims to open a space of discussion and reflection for understanding how museology is changing and adapting to societal and ecological challenges, especially after the hard times of the pandemic crisis which we have experienced and we are still experiencing. We have gone through hard times, but these sad and dark times have also been an opportunity for opening up spaces of reflection and transnational connections, including the one which has led to the making of this series, and many more, such as the Italian-Brazilian meetings, which have generated a chart of cooperation on eco-museums and community museums.
Nous voici donc en face d'une série de webinaires qui vise à ouvrir des espaces de discussion et de réflexion pour comprendre comment la muséologie évolue et s'adapte aux défis écologiques de la société, surtout après les moments difficiles de la crise pandémique que nous vivons encore. Nous avons traversé des moments difficiles, mais ils ont également été l'occasion d'ouvrir des espaces de réflexion et de connexion transnationales, compris celui qui nous a conduit à faire ce projet. Et bien plus, comme les rencontres italo-brésiliennes qui ont généré un tableau de coopération sur les écosystèmes et les musées communautaires.
Before leaving the floor to Giuseppe Reina, let me say that despite I don't have a background in museology, as I told, I hold a master degree in engineering and architecture and a doctoral degree in ecological and landscape planning, I'm triggered about the transdisciplinary intersections and overlaps that we are going to discover. After Giuseppe, I'll give you some practical examples of that. So please, Giuseppe, welcome to this talk. Giuseppe will discuss about eco-museums, one of the forms of community-based museology that we are going to meet along this day, with a specific focus on the Italian debate, one of the various contexts that we are going to virtually visit along this journey.
Avant de laisser la parole à Giuseppe, permettez-moi de dire que malgré je n'ai pas une formation en muséologie, comme je suis titulaire d'un master en ingénierie et d'un doctorat en aménagement écologique et paysager, je suis déclenché par les intersections disciplinaires que nous allons découvrir. Après Giuseppe, je donnerai un exemple pratique. Alors, s'il vous plaît, Giuseppe, bienvenue à cette conférence. Giuseppe parlera des commissaires, une des formes de muséologie communautaire que nous allons rencontrer au cours de cette journée, avec un accent particulier sur les débats italiens, un des différents contextes que nous allons virtuellement visiter au cours de ce voyage.
Giuseppe will speak in Italian and you will have the translation in the slides, the French translation in the slides. Please, Giuseppe, the microphone.
Olè. Buongiorno, bonjour. Giusy, fai scorrere tu le immagini, le slide?
Sì.
Ok.
Is it possible to put the slide in full screen, please, Giusy?
It is already in full screen in my computer, so okay. I don't know. Okay. Can you see it? Would be the first slide with pictures. État de conservation du paysage. Is there?
We don't see the full screen. We see the presentation, the whole window.
Okay. Just give me 1 second, and I'll try to change this. Can you see the full screen now?
Okay.
Yes.
Okay, thank you.
Okay, strumenti di tutela attiva e partecipazione per la gestione del patrimonio territoriale, gli ecomusei. Stato di conservazione del paesaggio italiano. I paesaggi storici italiani sono sempre meno riconoscibili, mentre assai raramente i cambiamenti in atto danno luogo alla produzione di nuovi paesaggi identificabili e coerenti. Chi percorre oggi l'Italia, diceva Barthes, troppo spesso avverte la sensazione di un discorso bruscamente interrotto, di un processo di significazione che è stato traumaticamente intercettato da qualcosa di estraneo o di incoerente. La riqualificazione dei contenuti paesistici ambientali del territorio nazionale non consiste soltanto nella cancellazione, nell'offuscamento dei segni identitari, nella frantumazione dell'unitarietà di piccola e grande scala o del crescente inquinamento delle condizioni ambientali. Dietro a questi aspetti vi è una crisi più generale e profonda che riguarda le ragioni stesse dell'abitare e quindi quei processi di territorializzazione mediante le quali le organizzazioni entrano in rapporto diretto con la loro terra. La perdita dell'identità dei luoghi della postmodernità, la perdita dell'identità è il riflesso di una frattura nei processi di identificazione, di appropriazione e di autorappresentazione delle comunità locali, nella loro incapacità di far significare le cose, sopraffatte dalla spregiudicatezza delle forze esogene che imprimono il loro marchio reale. I beni comuni, il territorio frutto di processi coevolutivi di lunga durata fra civilizzazioni antropiche e ambiente, è un deposito stratificato di sedimenti materiali e cognitivi che si configurano come patrimonio collettivo, dunque beni comuni per eccellenza, che possono essere posti al centro delle sperimentazioni di modelli socio-economici alternativi. Cosa fare? Dunque la questione dell'uso collettivo di questo immenso patrimonio diviene una guida e una condizione imprescindibile per la ricerca di nuove forme di conoscenza, produzione e riproduzione sociale del bene stesso, a fronte dell'attuale dominio esclusivo di Stato e mercato nella sua gestione. Una nuova idea di sviluppo ecosostenibile. Ciò che ha sollecitato la riflessione sullo sviluppo ecosostenibile è stato un pronunciato sforzo di superare l'idea di uno sviluppo esogeno dall'alto, banalizzante delle specifiche soggettività territoriali, per promuovere invece l'idea di uno sviluppo endogeno ed autocentrato sulle stanze delle comunità. Reinterpretare il territorio. Le esperienze in atto in vari paesi europei e non hanno dimostrato che è possibile promuovere dal basso progetti culturali innovativi come gli ecomusei, che mirano a esaltare il territorio come ambito privilegiato delle relazioni uomo-natura, come luogo dei saperi delle comunità locali, come testimonianza dei valori ambientali, come spazio che mette in sinergia le capacità degli abitanti per avviare processi di sviluppo durevoli e autosostenibili. L'approccio della progettazione ecomuseale. La prospettiva entro cui collocare conoscenza, tutela, valorizzazione del patrimonio storico locale non va certamente nel senso di musealizzare il territorio, se questo significa rifiutarne i cambiamenti ed opporsi a un'idea di sviluppo e trasformazione. L'ecomuseo si propone piuttosto di individuare, comprendere e selezionare i molteplici e stratificati valori di cui un territorio è espressione, proponendo la necessità di preservarne, per quanto possibile, i caratteri distintivi, anche quando si pianificano e attuano trasformazioni di carattere radicale, affinché permanga il senso dei luoghi da trasmettere alle future generazioni. Centri di interpretazione. Centri di interpretazione territoriale. Gli ecomusei costituiscono dei veri e propri laboratori territoriali che mirano non solo all'inventariazione, documentazione e conservazione del patrimonio, ma anche alla sua condivisione e valorizzazione creativa, aperta verso l'esterno e proiettata verso la sperimentazione, lo scambio e l'innovazione espressa attraverso il continuo ridefinirsi di azioni e relazioni tra soggetti individuali e collettivi. La carta di Catania, ottobre 2007. L'ecomuseo è una pratica partecipata di valorizzazione del patrimonio culturale, materiale e immateriale, elaborata e sviluppata da un soggetto organizzato, espressione di una comunità locale, nella prospettiva dello sviluppo sostenibile. Evoluzione del concetto di museo. Integrare la tutela, la valorizzazione, l'identità culturale, stimolare la partecipazione e creare un rapporto fra patrimonio territoriale e sviluppo rappresenta la nuova frontiera museale, un processo evidenziato anche dall'evoluzione che l'ICOM propose nel concetto di museo nell'Assemblea plenaria di Seul nel 2004, modificando in parte quello dello statuto del 1951. Il museo è un'istituzione permanente, senza scopo di lucro, al servizio della società e del suo sviluppo, è aperta al pubblico e compie ricerche che riguardano le testimonianze materiali e immateriali dell'umanità e del suo ambiente, le acquisisce, le conserva, le comunica e soprattutto le espone ai fini di studio, educazione e diletto. L'evoluzione dell'ideologia ecomuseale. Rispetto ad altre esperienze di museologia alternativa, sviluppatesi a partire dagli anni 70, sia la Nouvelle Museologie francese, sia da altri movimenti simili, impegnati nella democratizzazione, decolonizzazione e ridefinizione in chiave pluralistica delle pratiche e istituzioni museali, gli ecomusei furono elaborati soprattutto a partire dall'esperienza di antropologi e museologi nel campo dei musei etnografici e di cultura popolare e dall'interazione con contesti rurali e periferici. Pertanto si differenziarono e si caratterizzarono per la loro attenzione primaria ai processi di riscoperta e rivalutazione della dimensione locale e delle componenti sia materiali sia immateriali alla radice dell'identità dei luoghi, intesi quali patrimonio diffuso e bene comune da salvaguardare e valorizzare mediante la partecipazione attiva degli abitanti. Il termine ecomuseo. Il termine ecomuseo il termine ecomuseo. Il termine ecomuseo, introdotto in Francia nel 1971 da Hugo de Varin, fu definito in occasione della nona conferenza generale di ICOM di Gione da Robert Poyard, ministro francese dell'ambiente. Il 3 settembre 1971, davanti a 500 museologi di tutto il mondo, il ministro dell'ambiente francese pronunciò e ufficializzò il termine. Noi ci muoviamo verso quello che alcuni definiscono già ecomuseo, un approccio vivente attraverso il quale il pubblico e i giovani in primo luogo si riappropriano della grammatica di base dell'uomo, delle sue cose, del suo ambiente, visti nella loro evoluzione. Il primo ecomuseo. Comunemente si ritiene che Le Creusot rappresenti il primo e puro esempio di ecomuseo, un progetto di museo sull'uomo e sull'industria mineraria di quel territorio, il più possibile vicino alla storia sociale degli abitanti. Tra il 1971 e il 1974, sotto la guida di Hugues de Varin e Georges Riviere, nacque la comunità urbana di Le Creusot, cittadina mineraria francese, che aveva abbandonato lo sfruttamento delle miniere. Nel 1974 questa esperienza di riconversione sperimentale del sito industriale prese il nome di Ecomuseo e contribuì all'arricchimento della riflessione sulla territorialità e sulla partecipazione della popolazione. Diffusione degli ecomusei nel mondo. Semplificando le fasi storiche dello sviluppo ecomuseale, si può classificare la diffusione di queste strutture territoriali nel mondo in tre grandi periodi e bacini. Negli anni 70 e 80 la Francia, la Norvegia, la Svezia e il Portogallo vedono una crescente diffusione del fenomeno. Nello stesso periodo anche l'Italia e la Spagna si avvicinano senza ancora definirlo. Negli anni 80 l'interesse verso questa nuova forma di sviluppo e gestione del patrimonio culturale locale si espande nel mondo francofono d'oltremare, nel Canada, in particolare nella regione del Quebec e in Brasile. Dagli anni 90, anche in Cina e in India, nuove potenze economiche in continua ascesa si iniziano a diffondere gli ecomusei. Reti regionali e gli ecomusei. In Italia, in particolare, le reti regionali nascono dal 95 con le leggi regionali e gli ecomusei, con l'obiettivo di promuovere l'integrazione nella progettazione fra ambiti territoriali e definire sistemi di accreditamento e certificazione necessari per conferire una maggiore qualità e visibilità ai progetti ecomuseali. Il network regionale nascono proprio dalla necessità di creare un dialogo serio e continuo tra i siti ecomuseali e tra questi e le altre istituzioni preposte allo sviluppo territoriale. Le componenti degli ecomusei. L'ecomuseo si caratterizza, come scrive De Varin nel 2005, con il territorio, il patrimonio e la popolazione, che si contrappongono alle componenti museali classiche identificate in collezione immobile e pubblico. Il territorio. L'ecomuseo non sottrae il patrimonio territoriale ai luoghi, ma al contrario diventa chiave di lettura del territorio e quindi anche uno strumento, un progetto di significazione di elementi patrimoniali concorrenti alla riappropriazione identitaria dei luoghi da parte della collettività. Il patrimonio. Il patrimonio dell'ecomuseo. Il patrimonio dell'ecomuseo è inteso non come una parte, come l'arte o la scienza o l'archeologia o l'etnografia, ma come tutto ciò che per una comunità è degno di essere considerato tale. Il prefisso eco, nell'intento di chi inventò questo termine, serviva proprio per identificare tutto ciò che un tempo i greci indicavano con la parola oikos, cioè la complessità delle relazioni ambientali all'interno di una comunità, i numerosi intrecci e le stesse interazioni fra uomo è natura. La comunità, influenzando le opinioni, sentimenti e comportamenti della popolazione a cui si rivolge, l'ecomuseo può consolidare il rapporto di appartenenza della comunità al proprio territorio, aumentando la consapevolezza dell'individuo nella percezione del luogo in cui vive, la conoscenza del patrimonio in cui è detentore, l'adesione a determinate scelte dell'amministrazione locale, la preferenza di comportamenti virtuosi nella conservazione del proprio ambiente, la scelta di certe progettualità rispetto ad altre. Presupposti della progettazione ecomuseale. Fare un ecomuseo presuppone oggi un progetto culturale, una specificità territoriale, una potenzialità di gestione e iniziativa, un disegno degli attori interni e una volontà amministrativa adeguati alle finalità di un'opera difficile, costosa e, sia detto con chiarezza, non indispensabile o almeno non necessaria se non si propone finalità innovative e capacità di promozione culturale collettiva. L'Ecomuseo è un investimento culturale complesso con un'azione sul territorio progressiva che deve funzionare istituzionalmente tutto l'anno e in direzioni diverse per conservarsi e rinnovarsi. Scegliere l'Ecomuseo come investimento non significa dunque esibire oggetti al turista, ma creare un'istituzione capace di operare in autonomia, in tempi adeguati, per massimizzare la produttività culturale innescata con la sua apertura. Le cinque principali fasi di startup della progettazione ecomuseale. L'area di intervento, definita nella fase iniziale superando confini amministrativi, tenendo conto delle caratteristiche di omogeneità rispetto al tema generale dell'ecomuseo, individuando al suo interno le possibili risorse umane e le istituzioni pubbliche e private utili al progetto. 2. Incontri preliminari. Fin da principio deve essere chiaro l'aspetto partecipativo del progetto. Negli incontri ristretti, allargati, con enti, associazioni e cittadinanza, si possono presentare l'idea generale e lo spirito dell'iniziativa, raccogliere informazioni su pratiche culturali già avviate o idee progettuali compatibili con l'ecomuseo. Se le condizioni iniziali sono favorevoli, si può avviare uno studio di fattibilità e quindi il progetto esecutivo, attivando meccanismi di promozione del patrimonio locale e successivamente di gestione dell'ecomuseo. Il sistema autorizzante è basato sulla capacità dell'ecomuseo di generare subito valore pubblico e quindi benefici per la comunità. La leva strategica su cui è necessario agire perché questa prospettiva produca risultati è la legittimazione determinata dall'intensità dell'interazione che l'ecomuseo riuscirà a definire con i diversi attori che ne riconosceranno il valore prodotto. La gestione interna analizza le variabili organizzative interne e lo sviluppo di competenze di natura scientifica e organizzativa per far fronte all'attività propria dell'ecomuseo. 5. La gestione economica finanziaria dovrebbe mirare a una sempre minore dipendenza dai fondi pubblici, tentando una sostanziale autosostenibilità economico-finanziaria. La variabile strategica per raggiungere tale obiettivo si baserà sulla capacità che avrà l'Ecomuseo di lavorare sulla progettazione europea, sulla formazione interna dei volontari e sull'organizzazione di eventi per la raccolta fondi. La progettazione ecomuseale in tre fasi. La progettazione ecomuseale si struttura attraverso un percorso partecipativo su più fasi, finalizzate all'individuazione, alla conoscenza e alla trasmissione dei valori costitutivi del patrimonio territoriale nelle sue componenti ambientali, urbanistiche, paesaggistiche, antropologiche, che divengono le precondizioni per la costruzione e lo sviluppo locale autosostenibile. Individuazione. Per l'individuazione del patrimonio territoriale nella progettazione ecomuseale, le mappe di comunità sono state considerate dalla maggior parte degli ecomusei italiani gli strumenti privilegiati per l'inventario partecipativo di raccolta e autorappresentazione dal punto di vista delle comunità da affiancare e sovrapporre a strumenti classici considerati più oggettivi di analisi territoriale. La conoscenza. Il trattamento del patrimonio territoriale richiede, per utilizzare come risorse i valori individuati dalle pratiche di lavoro collettive, la costruzione di quadri conoscitivi in grado di interpretarli e analizzarli in forma integrata. La ricerca per rappresentare l'identità degli ambiti ecomuseali si è concretizzata nella costruzione sperimentale degli atlanti del patrimonio territoriale, strumenti specifici di interpretazione e rappresentazione di sintesi dei quadri conoscitivi che evidenziano le interrelazioni delle invarianti strutturali, elementi costitutivi delle specificità territoriali. La trasmissione. 3. Un passaggio successivo al riconoscimento, alla descrizione e alla rappresentazione dell'entità del luogo attraverso la selezione delle sue invarianti è la costruzione condivisa dello statuto dei luoghi, un corpus di regole, vincoli e prescrizioni con cui i piani e progetti di trasformazione del territorio si misurano. La costruzione degli statuti richiede necessariamente un lungo processo partecipativo che conduca ad un autoriconoscimento condiviso delle regole d'uso e di trasformazione del territorio nell'interesse collettivo attraverso i piani di azione locale. La costruzione di scenari strategici, così articolati in obiettivi, strategie e azioni, ha nella loro produzione sociale la garanzia della loro realizzabilità. Collettore di progettualità territoriale. L'Ecomuseo è chiamato a svolgere, lungi dall'essere organismo separato e autoreferenziale, il ruolo di collettore di progettualità comunitaria, strumento di coordinamento di una rete di organismi decentrati sul territorio per azioni orientate all'autosostenibilità locale. Nella mobilitazione di interventi e idee per riqualificare gli ambiti territoriali, in linea con le politiche di riconversione ecologica promosse dalla UE, nel capacizzare e responsabilizzare in una logica di network la comunità nella gestione condivisa dei beni comuni, nel saper coinvolgere trasversalmente gli enti e i soggetti nelle pratiche partecipate per azione orientata all'economia circolare, nell'intercettare e accrescere il capitale sociale. Per ultimo, facilitare i processi ecomuseali. La lente ecomuseale è la focalizzazione delle conoscenze e delle competenze che dovrebbero essere utilizzate dall'ecomuseo per facilitare i processi. 1. Comprendere i bisogni e le aspirazioni di diversi gruppi sociali. Condurre ricerche sulle realtà politiche, sociali, economiche, nonché sulla possibilità di operare cambiamenti delle regole normative e di prassi di gestione del patrimonio territoriale. Studiare le convinzioni e le usanze delle comunità locali, identificando quelle che possono rivelarsi più utili al sostegno dei diritti e dell'empowerment. Comprendere gli orientamenti politici dei potenziali sostenitori, come i gruppi di pressione e i movimenti della società civile, nonché la politica più utile alla costruzione di alleanze efficaci. Imparare il linguaggio culturale, sviluppare la cultural fluency, indispensabile per apprendere e trattare. Sviluppare tecniche e strumenti per facilitare la comunicazione, la mediazione, la trattativa necessarie per costruire rapporti di fiducia, risolvere i conflitti ed incoraggiare l'ownership delle politiche e delle attività promosse in difesa dei beni comuni. Thanks. Grazie.
Thank you, Giuseppe, for your contribution. And now I would like to give a practical example.
Giuseppe, can you put out? Yes.
Thanks.
So thank you again. And now I'll give a practical example of what Giuseppe has just discussed, considering that ecomuseums may change and they form different organizational structures depending on the context where they are conceived and experienced. But before that, let me go a bit more into the intersection between my field of research, which is urban and regional planning, and museology.
Merci, Giuseppe, pour votre intéressante contribution. Maintenant, je voudrais faire la pratique de ce dont Giuseppe vient de parler. Considérant que les écomusées peuvent changer et former une structure organisationnelle en fonction du contexte dans lequel ils sont conçus et expérimentés. Mais avant cela, laissez-moi aller un peu plus dans l'intersection entre mon domaine de recherche, l'urbanisme et l'aménagement du territoire, et la muséologie.
Planning is concerned with the relationships between individuals, collective subjects, such as informal groups, associations, NGOs, etc., and institutions, and their environment of life. This system of relations is what we call landscape. Planners which focus on landscape explore the way landscape is perceived and shaped. How could it be transformed in a way that allows all humans and non-humans to have a decent life on Earth? and how to guarantee basic rights for all. So planners deal with change and institutional arrangements.
La planification concerne les relations entre les individus, les sujets collectifs comme groupes informels, associations, ONG et les institutions, et leur environnement de vie. Ce système de relations est ce que nous appelons les paysages. Les planificateurs qui se concentrent sur les paysages explorent la façon dont le paysage est perçu, comment pourrait-il être transformé d'une manière qui permet aux humains et aux non-humains d'avoir une vie décente sur Terre et comment garantir les droits fondamentaux par tous. Les planificateurs s'occupent donc du changement et des arrangements institutionnels.
And my specific research approach to planning is called action research. And the research group I belong to in Catania, which is called Laboratory for Ecological Planning and Design of the Territory, has a long-lasting tradition of action research development. This means that we have engaged in long-term partnerships with local communities, especially with distressed communities, in order to advance knowledge collectively while producing transformative outcomes.
Mon approche de recherche spécifique à la planification est appelée recherche-action. Le groupe de recherche dont je fais partie à Catane, qui s'appelle Laboratoire pour la planification écologique et la conception du territoire, a une longue tradition de développement de la recherche-action. Cela signifie que nous nous engageons dans des partenariats à long terme avec les communautés locales, en particulier dans les collectivités en difficulté, afin de faire progresser les connaissances collectives en produisant des résultats transformateurs.
And in this perspective, museology is crucial for what we do. From my understanding of museology, and of course I could be wrong, but I'm here for learning, museology is concerned with preserving and telling the memory of societies through use various approaches and means. And this is crucial because societies learn from history, and the way history is told and understood shapes the way present and the future are planned and how transformations occur. This is why I think that a transdisciplinary contamination between museology and ecological planning is important, and I'm actually here for that, for exploring the potentialities of this contamination in a transnational perspective.
Et dans cette perspective, la muséologie est cruciale pour ce que nous faisons. À mon avis, et je pourrais me tromper, mais je suis ici pour apprendre, la muséologie se préoccupe de préserver et de raconter la mémoire des sociétés à travers différentes approches et moyens. C'est crucial parce que ce que les sociétés apprennent de l'histoire et la façon dont l'histoire est racontée et comprise explique comment le présent et l'avenir sont planifiés et comment les transformations se produisent. C'est pour ça que je pense qu'une contamination transdisciplinaire entre muséologie et planification écologique est importante. Et je suis ici pour explorer les potentialités de cette contamination dans une perspective transnationale.
And as I said at the beginning, my grant is sponsored by the European Social Fund through a project that is called Attraction and International Mobility of Researchers. The University of Catania Department of Civil Engineering and Architecture, which is where I come from, is beneficiary of this EU project, and my university could apply as it is located in Sicily, South Italy, which is one of the less developed regions in Europe.
Comme j'ai dit au début, ma subvention est sponsorisée par le Fonds social européen dans le cadre d'un projet intitulé Attraction and International Mobility of Researchers. L'Université de Catane, département de génie civil et d'architecture d'où je viens, est le bénéficiaire de ce projet. Mon université pourrait appliquer car il est situé en Sicile, en Italie du Sud, qui est l'une des régions les moins développées en Europe.
So through my research project, I'm expected to advance knowledge in a way that is useful for advancing local development in terms of sustainable development. And I chose to spend this opportunity investigating the broad topic of new museology, eco-museums, community museums, because the local community I'm working with is actually experimenting what could be defined an eco-museal process in Eastern Sicily.
Donc, dans le cadre de mon projet de recherche, On s'attend que je fasse progresser les connaissances d'une façon qui soit utile pour faire avancer l'économie locale en termes de développement durable. Et j'ai choisi de profiter de cette occasion pour étudier les vastes sujets de la nouvelle muséologie, des écomusées et des musées communautaires, parce que la communauté locale avec laquelle je travaille expérimente en fait ce qui pourrait être d'être défini un processus écomuséal en Sicile orientale.
So that's why I'm interested in ecomuseums, because I've been working for 10 years with my research group and now with Giuseppe along the Simeto River, which runs for 113 kilometers in eastern Sicily, in the widest watershed of the island. From the neighboring mountains to the Catania coastal area, nurtured with waters that come from Mount Etna, which is the tallest active volcano in Europe, and it's a very beautiful place, and of course you are all invited.
C'est pour ça que je m'intéresse aux écomusées. Je travaille depuis 10 ans le long de la rivière Simeto, qui s'étend pour 113 km dans l'est de la Sicile, dans les bassins hydrographiques les plus larges de l'île, de Mont Nebrodi à la zone côtière de Catania, nourrie par les eaux qui viennent de l'Etna, le volcan le plus haut actif d'Europe. C'est un endroit magnifique et vous êtes tous invités.
So here, 10 municipalities, you can see them in the map, along the middle stretch of the river in the so-called valley, have signed the Simeto River Agreement, which is a voluntary effort of shared territorial governance aimed at preserving and valuing the natural cultural heritage of the valley and promoting local development. The agreement has been pushed by a coalition of community-based organizations called the Participatory Presidium, together with some researchers from the University of Catania, included me myself, engaged in the long-term community university partnership that, I said, started more than a decade ago. But the history of the community-based process is even longer, and you can find several publications if you're interested, but now I'll try to summarize.
Ici, 10 municipalités, vous pouvez voir la carte, le long de la partie centrale de la rivière, dans la soi-disant vallée, ont signé l'accord sur la rivière Simeto. Un effort volontaire de gouvernance territoriale partagée, visant à préserver et à valoriser la nature, le patrimoine culturel de la vallée et la promotion du développement local. L'accord a été poussé par une coalition d'organisations communautaires appelée le Presidium Participatif, avec quelques chercheurs de l'Université de Catane, dont moi-même, engagés dans un partenariat à long terme entre la communauté et l'université qui, comme j'ai dit, a commencé il y a plus de 10 ans. Mais l'histoire de ces procès communautaires est encore plus longue. Vous pouvez trouver plusieurs publications si vous êtes intéressé, mais je vais essayer de résumer.
So, in 2002, the Sicilian region issued a waste management plan, which would have required the construction of 4 up to 5 mega incinerators, one of those to be located inside a beautiful special area of conservation close to the Simeto River. The local community, creating alliances between various municipalities, opposed this plan. Through a social mobilization that was inspired by environmental justice principles and by a concern about suspected mafia infiltration on the Sicilian waste business. The mobilization was successful, the plan was withdrawn, but the local community decided not to stop after the protests. The associations kept organizing and asked some researchers from the University of Catania to start an experimental journey together to co-produce forms of local development inspired by the ethos of inter-intraspecies solidarity as an alternative to the model of development represented by the mega incinerator.
En 2002, la région de Sicile a publié un plan de gestion des déchets qui aurait exigé la construction de 4 à 5 méga-incinérateurs, l'un d'eux étant situé à l'intérieur d'une zone spéciale de conservation près de la rivière Simeto. La communauté locale, créant des alliances entre différentes municipalités, s'est opposée à ce plan avec une mobilisation sociale inspirée par des principes de justice environnementale et par une préoccupation au sujet de l'infiltration mafieuse présumée dans les déchets siciliens. La mobilisation a réussi et ce plan a été retiré. mais la communauté locale a décidé de s'arrêter pas après la manifestation. Les associations ont continué à s'organiser et ont demandé à certains chercheurs de l'Université de Catane de commencer un voyage ensemble, de coproduire des formes de développement local inspirées par un état de solidarité interespèces, comme alternative au modèle de développement représenté par les méga-incinérateurs.
In 2009-2010, we have conducted a first community mapping experiment. The community mapping in Italy, as Giuseppe just told, is a tool which many eco-museums use in order to explore the perception of landscape and the different relationships that people have with land and its use, with natural and cultural, material and immaterial heritage, exploring collective memories as well as ideas of transformations, not only in terms of potentialities, but of course also in terms of criticalities. So we have focused on issues as well as on shared values, identities and visions in order to draft a first bottom-up strategic plan.
En 2009-2010, nous avons mené une première expérience de cartographie communautaire. La cartographie communautaire en Italie est un outil que nombreux écomusées utilisent pour explorer la perception du paysage et les différents rapports que les gens ont avec la terre et son utilisation, avec le patrimoine naturel et culturel, matériel et immatériel, explorant la mémoire collective ainsi que les idées de transformation, non seulement en termes de potentialité, mais bien sûr en termes de criticité. Nous sommes donc concentrés sur les problèmes ainsi que sur les valeurs, identité et vision commune, afin de rédiger un premier plan stratégique.
Later on, we have continued mapping, organized participatory workshops, and prepared the first documents and a memorandum of understandings for engaging also local institutions into the bottom-up process. We have also applied for the National Strategy for Inner Areas, that is a ministerial program under the framework of the EU-Italian territorial cohesion policy. And the valley has been selected as an experimental area of national significance for the participatory process put in place. The strategy, which has been approved in 2018 and it's now moving into the implementation phase, will provide economic resources for strengthening services such as education, healthcare, and mobility, and sustaining some projects for local development in three municipalities of the valley, which are called Adrano, Biancavilla and Centuripe.
Plus tard, nous avons continué la cartographie, nous avons organisé des ateliers participatifs et préparé les premiers documents et un protocole d'accord pour impliquer également les institutions locales dans les procès. Nous avons également postulé pour la stratégie nationale pour les zones intérieures, qui est un programme ministériel dans le cadre de la politique de cohésion territoriale italienne de l'Union européenne. La Vallée a été sélectionnée comme zone expérimentale d'importance nationale pour les processus participatifs mis en place. La stratégie, qui a été approuvée en 2018 et qui entre maintenant dans la phase de mise en œuvre, fournira des ressources économiques pour renforcer les services tels que l'éducation, la santé et la mobilité, et soutenir certains projets de développement local dans trois municipalités de la Vallée: Adrano, Biancavilla e Centuripe.
Meanwhile, the Simeto River Agreement has been formalized and signed in 2015. It is a voluntary pact among 10 municipalities, the University of Catania and the Participatory Presidium. The last one is an umbrella organization which groups about 60 organizations. The agreement has experimented with a first triennium of shared governance and several other projects that have been funded thanks to the synergies that the agreement itself has created. Among them, there is a EU life project on adaptation to climate change, focused on processes of community learning for resilience, and now the direct beneficiaries in this case are municipalities of Paterno, Santa Maria di Licodia and Ragalna, and the entire valley is the strategic area.
Entretemps, l'accord sur la rivière Simeto a été officialisé, signé en 2015. Il s'agit d'un pacte volontaire entre 10 municipalités, l'Université de Catane et le Présidium participatif. La dernière est une organisation cadre qui regroupe une soixantaine d'organisations. L'accord a expérimenté un premier triennat de gouvernance partagée et plusieurs d'autres projets ont été financés grâce aux synergies que l'accord lui-même a créées. Parmi eux, il y a le projet EU-LIFE sur l'adaptation au changement climatique, concentré sur les procès d'apprentissage communautaire pour la résilience. Les bénéficiaires directs, dans ce cas, sont les municipalités de Paternò, Santa Maria di Licodia et Ragalla, et l'ensemble de la vallée et les domaines stratégiques.
So in this framework, the participatory presidium has recently decided to focus specifically on the idea of revitalizing heritage from a community-based perspective and has formed a specific teamwork that is experimenting ecomuseal actions. In a nutshell, we have continued the community mapping experimentation, and we are now starting another experiment that is the participatory inventory, asking people to collect memories, stories, and objects around several thematic assets through very simple questions and still with the support of user-friendly maps. The goal is to create a system of heritage that has been generated from the bottom up and could be integrated with expertise and top-down planning in order to reinforce the sense of belonging and the democratic dialogue among different social actors.
Dans ce cadre, le Presidium participatif a récemment décidé de se concentrer spécifiquement sur l'idée de revitaliser le patrimoine dans une perspective communautaire et a formé un travail d'équipe spécifique qui expérimente des actions écomuseales. En un mot, nous avons poursuivi l'expérimentation de la cartographie communautaire et commençons maintenant une autre expérience, qui est l'inventaire participatif, demandant aux gens de collecter des souvenirs, des histoires et des objets autour de plusieurs thématiques, à travers des questions très simples et toujours avec le soutien des cartes user-friendly. L'objectif est de créer un système de patrimoine issu de la base et pouvant être intégré à l'expertise et à la planification des sendons, afin de renforcer les sentiments d'appartenance et les dialogues démocratiques entre les différents acteurs sociaux.
In this phase, we have actually identified four pilot projects. The first one is called The River Exists, and it is dedicated to our friend and ecologist, Luigi Carlo Puglisi, who unfortunately passed away last spring. And he was very passionate about the importance and the role and the rights of the river for our territory. And with this project, we want to turn a light on it, as for years, the river valley has been used just as a huge dumping area. The second project is called Inclusive Heritage, and it is focused on inclusion of marginalized people and social ecological justice. The third one is called Museums Go to Farm, and it's focused on identifying connections between existing museums and the so-called cultural corridors all around the valley. And the fourth pilot project is called New Chains of Value, and it focuses on generating and sustaining small economic operations in the valley as an opportunity for the youth.
Au cours de cette phase, nous avons identifié quatre projets pilotes. Le premier s'intitule La rivière existe, et il est dédié à notre ami écologiste Luigi Carlo Puglisi, qui est malheureusement décédé le printemps dernier. Il était très passionné par l'importance et le rôle de la rivière pour notre territoire. Et avec ce projet, nous voulons l'éclairer, car depuis des années, la vallée de la rivière est utilisée comme une immense zone de déversement. Le deuxième projet, intitulé « Héritage inclusif », est axé sur l'inclusion des personnes marginalisées et sur la justice socio-écologique. Le troisième est intitulé « Les musées vont à la ferme ». Et elle est axée sur l'identification des liens entre les musées existants et les soi-disant corridors culturels tout autour de la vallée. Le quatrième projet pilote, intitulé « Nouvelle chaîne de valeur », est concentré sur la création et le maintien de petites opérations économiques dans la vallée comme une occasion pour les jeunes.
Currently, we are also committed to apply to a regional call which aims to recognize the existence of ecomuseums in Sicily. The way in which our regional law works is not to establish eco-museums as a top-down initiatives, rather is to recognize community-based experiences which are capable to interact with institutional frameworks in order to co-produce local development. Let me say that the law on eco-museums which we have in Sicily is a very good law. However, the way it has been implemented along the years has not always been consistent with its very own inspiring ethos.
Actuellement, nous nous engageons également à participer à un appel régional visant à reconnaître l'existence de ces communautés en Sicile. Le fonctionnement de notre loi régionale ne consiste pas à faire de les écomusées des initiatives top-down, mais plutôt à reconnaître les expériences communautaires capables d'interagir avec les cadres institutionnels, afin de coproduire le développement local. Permettez-moi de dire que la loi sur les écomusées que nous avons en Sicile est une bonne loi. Cependant, la façon dont elle a été mise en œuvre au fil des années n'a pas toujours été était conforme à sa propre philosophie aspirante.
Despite that, the Simeto community bounded around the participatory presidium together with the University of Catania is currently working intensively in order to gain recognition for its long-lasting process from the regional boards. This recognition is important to better structure this process into the institutional framework, and it also will help us in accessing the public funds, which we believe have to be spent with transparency through clear and participated decision-making processes. We're a bit still far from that in Sicily, but we are also working toward this end.
Malgré cela, la communauté du Simeto, limitée autour du Presidium participatif, avec l'Université de Catane, travaille actuellement intensivement afin d'obtenir la reconnaissance de son processus de longue durée par les conseils régionaux. Cette reconnaissance est importante pour mieux structurer ses procès dans le cadre institutionnel et elle nous aidera également à accéder aux fonds publics, qui, à notre avis, doivent être dispensés avec transparence au moyen de procès décisionnels clairs et participatifs. Nous sommes encore un peu loin de cela en Sicile, mais nous travaillons aussi à cette fin.
So, as a visiting researcher at the University of Liegi, I'm here to acquire the knowledge and to find connections about what is happening in the Simeto River Valley and other parts of the world. And I think that there will be a mutual learning benefit. I have invited the activists of the Simeto Ecomuseums to attend this webinar series. Some of them are here today, some will join us during next webinars. And then in the closing conversation, they will be active museum people in the dialogue with Garlandini and Brulon.
Ainsi, en tant que chercheur invité à l'Université de Liège, je suis ici pour acquérir les connaissances et trouver des liens sur ce qui se passe entre la vallée de la rivière Simeto et d'autres parties du monde. Et je pense qu'il y aura un bénéfice d'apprentissage mutuel. J'ai invité les activistes de l'écomusée du Simeto à assister à ces séries de webinaires. Certains d'entre eux sont ici aujourd'hui et d'autres se joindront à nous lors des prochains webinaires. Puis, dans la conversation de clôture, ils seront des gens des musées actifs dans le dialogue avec Garlandini et Brulon.
And finally, we plan to establish a long-lasting collaboration among our universities. So maybe at one point, I hope you will have the opportunity to come and visit Sicily. And beyond that, you are always more than welcome to come in the Simeto River Valley, where you will find a local community which will be happy to host you, and you would see how people there are trying hard to reshape the trajectories of development in the light of new awareness of their history.
Enfin, nous prévoyons d'établir une collaboration durable entre notre université. Donc j'espère que vous aurez l'occasion de venir visiter la Sicile. Au-delà de cela, vous êtes toujours plus que bienvenue à venir dans la vallée de la rivière Simeto. Vous trouverez une communauté locale qui sera heureuse de vous accueillir et vous verrez comment les gens là-bas s'efforcent de remodeler les trajectoires du développement à la lumière d'une nouvelle prise de conscience de l'histoire.
And now I would like to leave the floor to Guido Carruba, which is a young student that has just done the translation, and he comes from Sicily. And he can share some comments from his generational perspectives on the value of ecomuseal processes, such as the one they have just described along the Simeto River, as an opportunity for shaping a more just, inclusive, ecological-oriented food future. Thank you, and please, Guido, share your thoughts.
Maintenant, je voudrais donner la parole à Guido Carruba, jeune étudiant originaire de Sicile, qui peut partager quelques commentaires. Et son point de vue générationnel sur la vallée des processus écomuséaux, comme celle que je viens de décrire le long de la rivière Simeto, comme une occasion de façonner un avenir plus juste, inclusif et écologique. Alors, premièrement, je te remercie pour m'avoir donné l'occasion de participer à cette conférence très intéressante. Je crois que cette expérience de nouvelle muséologie peut vraiment être une occasion pour les jeunes, qui de plus en plus s'éloignent de notre terre, à comprendre et vivre mieux la nature, les potentialités de la Sicile et acquérir les compétences nécessaires pour relancer notre territoire avec une optique différente, loin des logiques d'exploitation qui l'ont caractérisé jusqu'à aujourd'hui avec les grandes installations industrielles comme les raffineries, mais au contraire, en harmonie avec notre patrimoine environnemental. C'est pour ça que je crois que l'université joue un rôle dans ce projet. Merci beaucoup à nouveau et je te laisse à nouveau la parole, Giussi.
Thank you. So now we have time for questions and answers.
Yes, I can manage this, Giussi, because you are one of the ones to answer the questions. So I think we had a little problem, technical problem today, because we planned that you could put your names in the chat to inscribe to the discussion. But if it's not possible, you can raise the hand and I ask the students to help me to control the order to not make confusion. We are open to the questions. Giuseppe Reina needs to go out to leave 15 minutes before 11, so we can prioritize questions to him, and Jules and Guido will stay with him until 11. I don't know how much questions we will have, but if we can continue in the next sessions, if we cannot have time to everybody speak today, on next Friday is only two interventions, so maybe we have more time to discussion. To begin, if you want, I'm very curious to know the partners, the people engaged in this project in Italy. So if they don't mind to open their cameras and say hello, I will be very happy to know the other people from Simeto Vale.
I actually checked right now the names, but yes. And I cannot. Okay. Okay.
Hello. There's another person?
I think no.
If you want to introduce who is Francesco Valerani.
Yes, I'm from Ca' Foscari University, Venice, and I'm very interested in your work about eco museums because we have just set up a UNESCO chair in Venice focusing on water museums. So we are managing a global network about water museums. So we are very involved in international network of other reality, especially in developing countries. And our main goals is to improve collaboration with the main topic is the water. So when I was listening about the Simeto River, for me it was an amazing opportunity to make a relationship to improve to plan further collaborations So because in Veneto area, we have so many river corridors and so many navigation museums involved in the recovery of the memory of water memory is very important, you know, because of Venice. But not only the Venice, the monumental town, but also the inland, the network of rivers flowing through the lagoon. This is a very ecological and historical issues, especially the environmental in history or ecology history. So many topics that overlap with your main project, especially with Sicily. For this reason, I'm very involved to collaborate with you. And you can see in the other participants, we have Sara Lucchetta, that is a postdoc student that is working with us for more than 1 year. So, hi, Sara. So this is our, we have a larger group of scholars. So we can start a collaboration if you want. We can share the emails and so on. It's the first step to start this collaboration. Thank you for hosting us. If Sara, if you want to add any other remark.
Oh, well, good morning to everyone. Just want to thank you for the insightful presentations and examples. So I will be very glad to collaborate and to share experiences and knowledge. Thank you very much.
Thank you for being here. And yeah, can I answer in English and then someone can summarize in French probably? Okay.
Only to say, I will speak a little bit in French only to summarize, okay? Pour ceux qui ne comprennent pas en anglais, en effet, il y a des étudiants ici qui vont aussi nous aider un peu avec la traduction, mais vous pouvez attendre la vidéo avec les sous-titres sur YouTube dans les prochaines semaines. Mais Monsieur Francesco Valerian et Sara Lucchetta sont d'une université d'Italie et profite l'occasion pour faire les réseautages avec Giuse et Giuseppe parce qu'ils ont des projets proches. Je ne sais pas si j'ai fait un résumé correct. Est-ce que Megan peut aider s'il y a des détails ou d'incorrection dans l'information, s'il te plaît?
Oui, pas de souci, je peux aider pour la suite des traductions, mais ici, il me semble que tout a été dit et voilà, il faut, les étudiants du cours, n'hésitez pas à me contacter par Messenger ou quoi que ce soit si vous avez un souci de compréhension.
Ok, merci. Donc, Josie, you can answer.
Thank you. And yes, of course, we are more than interested to start a collaboration. So we will start exchanging, of course, email. But of course, you are invited to all the webinars that we're going to do from now up to April. There will be this interesting final conversation, which will summarize all the reflections that we will generate through the webinar. So I think this one should be a good way for starting exchanging idea. And meanwhile, yes, of course, let's create connection between North and South Italy. And I don't know if Giuseppe wants to add anything in Italian. I can translate, but Giuseppe is very active in the national network of eco-museums, so that would be an opportunity to link what you're doing also with the national network of eco-museums.
Megan, est-ce que tu peux traduire, s'il te plaît?
Excusez-moi, je vais avoir un problème de connexion. Je n'ai pas tout entendu Je me propose de réécouter l'enregistrement après et de recontacter les étudiants. Je suis vraiment désolée.
Elle a dit simplement qu'elle est de commencer une collaboration et que Giuseppe, qui est très en lien avec le réseau national des écomusées, peut aider à faire cette connexion.
Merci. So we are open to other comments and questions. If you cannot put your names in the chat, you can raise your hand. Nous sommes ouverts pour les questions ou commentaires. Vous pouvez lever la petite main qui est au dessus. Est-ce qu'il y a des inscriptions? Je ne vois pas.
Yes, we have one.
C'est Gilbert Nicolas du Liban. So, you prefer if I ask in English or French?
If it's better in English, I think, to Gilles and to Giuseppe in French.
Okay, so I will ask my question in English. So I'm a museology student in Lebanon, and it's the first time that I hear talking about eco-museums. And I was wondering if this kind of eco-museum, this kind of idea can be implemented in an urban place, not just rural areas, especially that we know that in ancient cities or modern cities, there is different cultures, different people from different regions that lives together. So I don't know if this idea of eco-museum can go in a city, especially that we are losing, mainly here in Lebanon, and I think everywhere in the world, we are losing this cultural richness of a city and all the what comes with the heritage and everything around the culture of the city. So that was my question. Thank you so much.
Thank you. I'll answer and then I'll leave also the answer for Giuseppe. And I can translate in English and we can then translate in French. But yes, of course, they can be also set up in cities. And as a matter of fact, in the region where I come from, there is a nice ecomuseal experience inside a city, which is Palermo, and that ecomuseum is an urban ecomuseum, and that's one of the many examples of other urban ecomuseums. We have another one in central Italy, close to Rome. So, of course, the concept can be adapted also to the urban environment, as long as it is based on community, on a community involvement, and it is based on this process that Giuseppe has just shown to us, the phases that he has shown to us, but it can be adapted. And as I said before, it changes the organizational form depending on the context where it comes out, but could be a rural context or an urban context.
Bien sûr que le commissaire se peut adapter à un paysage urbain. Et en fait, il y a déjà un exemple, en Palermo, par exemple, d'écomusées urbaines. Les écomusées peuvent s'adapter à différents contextes. Et il dépend des sujets qui les font et qui participe à cette expérience.
Giuseppe, vuoi aggiungere? Vuoi aggiungere in italiano? Io traduco. Il microfono. Il microfono.
Siamo in una fase di profonda transazione del concetto ecomuseale, e il tema è quello di immaginare rispetto al momento quindi la ripartenza dopo la pandemia e dopo la riconversione, dopo questo processo, bisogna accentuare la riconversione ecologica, e quindi i presupposti cambiano, è un processo sempre in movimento. Puoi iniziare così, tradurre, poi io continuo a dire qualche altra cosa.
So, I'll do the English and then we do the French. So yes, as we are in a transition phase, ecological transition, and after pandemic, everything is, we are reframing many concepts and tools, as well as for the Eco Museum concept and experiences and as a tool, and the debate is reflecting on this transition phase. So probably even things will change even inside the ecomuseal debate due to the changing times.
Nous sommes en une phase de profond changement du concept de l'écomusée. Surtout après la pandémie, on va voir comment adapter ces projets à les temps d'aujourd'hui. Surtout que la transition écologique doit être rapide.
Rispetto anche alle ultime parole di Hugues de Varin nel libro pubblicato nel 2017 in Francia e che presenteremo il 29 marzo nella traduzione italiana, Hugues de Varin parla di un progetto ecomuseale che deve essere sempre più coesivo e trasversale, facendo riferimento soprattutto a tre pilastri, riprendendo il suffisso eco dell'ecomuseo, in modo particolare per l'ecosocialità, l'economia e l'ecologia. Sono tre temi fondamentali che devono essere messi al centro dell'autosostenibilità dei territori.
So Giuseppe just recalled the words of Hugues de Varin and his last book that has been published in 2015, and we are going to present it March 29 in its Italian version. So in that book, de Varin talks about the importance of having eco-museums as tools for social cohesion, and they have to be integrated tool, and they have to be founded on three pillars, reusing the prefix eco in its Greek meaning oikos. He uses that in its three dimensions. Eco-sociality, so the fact that eco is also related to society, social, ecological, it's always a concept that goes together, economic and ecology as ecology. So he says that eco-museums now, in these times, they need to be founded on these three pillars. And that's, so going back to your question, yes, they of course, in an urban environment, you have also these three necessities, and also the necessity for social cohesion, and ecomuseums can be a tool for that.
Thank you so much.
Par rapport alle livres publiés par De Varin, il croit que les ecomuseums doivent être vus comme un projet le plus inclusif possible. Le mot ecomusée est fondé sur trois principes. Tous concentrés sur les préfixes éco, comme la nature, l'inclusion et la socialité.
Ultimo punto che volevo sottolineare è che nei dibattiti con Hugues de Varin in questi vent'anni viene sempre più fuori un elemento che l'ecomuseologia e gli ecomusei a livello locale devono rappresentare: essere un soggetto politico. Un soggetto politico che condiziona le scelte degli amministratori, delle comunità che sono coinvolte in questo processo, ma soprattutto condiziona le scelte degli attori esterni. E diventa sempre più strategico, l'idea anche in questa fase di conversione ecologica che gli amministratori locali siano in grado di avere una progettazione strategica, e su questo l'ecomuseo può avere un ruolo, ruolo fondamentale.
After years of conversations and debate with the Varenne, that Giuseppe had with the Varenne, now what is clear is that the Ecomuseum has to be a political actor, a political subject. That's what the Ecomuseum has to be. And this political subject has to be able to interact with local administrators, to affect the decision-making process, to interact and affect also the actions from external actors. And in these times of ecological transitions, it is important that the Ecomuseum plays an active role in the definition of strategies that local administrations have to adopt and implement for the ecological transition.
Les écomusées doivent être un projet politique qui doit conditionner les actions des acteurs externes, aussi la collaboration avec les institutions locales pour participer à la décision avec un rôle actif.
Il semble qu'il n'y a pas de questions de l'audience maintenant, donc je vais poser une question à Giuseppe. So I will put a question for Giuseppe in the time we wait for other questions from the audience. I'm interested to understand deeper the difference, or maybe they are the same, but if you can comment this methodology, map de communauté ou cartographie communautaire, entre cette between this strategy and the participative inventory, because in Brazil, in Portugal, we use a lot a methodology called participatory inventory. So if you could comment if they are the same, if they are different. Donc seulement pour ceux qui ne comprennent pas anglais, pour commenter la différence entre les maps de communauté ou cartographie communautaire et l'inventaire participatif, qui est une méthodologie qui me semble un peu proche, que beaucoup utilisée au Brésil et au Portugal. Merci.
E le mappe di comunità sono state certamente scelte, sperimentate sul territorio in questi ultimi 20 anni, quindi è un progetto abbastanza rodato, che funziona, utilizzato, ma ultimamente, negli ultimi 5 anni, diciamo nel dibattito degli ecomusei, si è resi conto che spesso quelle invarianti predefinite, cioè attraverso un lavoro partecipato in queste mappe, di fatto divengono poi poco implementate nei processi. Uno, perché le mappe vanno continuamente aggiornate, il territorio cambia e quindi vanno continuamente aggiornate. L'aspetto importante è che questi elementi identificati sulle mappe di comunità devono interagire tra loro, evitare che la mappa di comunità diventi una scheda di catalogazione. Dobbiamo rendere il più possibile attive. Per fare questo vanno costruiti degli strumenti dove questi elementi interagiscono tra di loro, dove i saperi immateriali diventano elemento di interconnessione tra le invarianti individuate. Questo passaggio tra le mappe di comunità è un altro strumento utile a fare in modo che questi elementi interagiscono, vengono chiamati atlanti del patrimonio, dove in questi atlanti si definiscono le regole comuni su cui far interagire questi elementi. Non so se sono stato chiaro. Posso far finta. Allora, andiamo.
Ok, so the community maps have been experimented for 20 years in our context in Italy. It's a tool that has been experimented a lot. And what are the limitations now that we have used that for 20 years? That sometimes people identified elements on the map, but then there was not a way for acting these elements in terms of creating actions related with these elements first. And the second problem was related with a lack of interaction between these elements. And a third thing was that the maps need to be constantly updated. These are the limitations that we have experienced use after 20 years of community mapping as tools used here in Italy. What we are trying to add now is to transform the community maps into heritage atlas, where the rules of how to use the territory has to emerge. So the Heritage Atlas is another tool that now is coming into the debate that put a focus on the rules of use of territory.
Les maps communautaires ont été élus dans les années dernières, mais nous avons noté que pas toujours elles ont été utilisées. Nous devons rendre cette map la plus active possible, de manière qu'elle soit favorisée la collaboration et l'intégration entre les sujets et la map. Autre point important est renouveler toujours les maps.
Merci. So,
the microphone, and there is a hand. Martina, raise the hand.
Okay, last question to Giuseppe. He has only 2 minutes.
Okay. Short question. So I'll be very, very quick, very rapid. So, thank you for the presentation. I really like the project. Also the project presented by Juicy, and I was very interested in your mentioning the question of the transition, so ecological transition, and the fact that the museum, the eco-museum concept is changing rapidly. At the same time, we see in urbanism that the city is also very rapidly changing, so the city is becoming more and more city territory, and so we can imagine that these inhabitants, new inhabitants, are more and more in contact with the territory and are immersed in the territory. And at the same time, we see that they are more and more detached from the knowledge of its functioning, something that was not there once. So, and I think this is quite an issue. At the same time, we have this sort of ecological crisis and the need to take care of the landscape. So we have these two aspects. So the fact that people are more and more immersed in the territory, and at the same time, we need for care. We have to take care of the landscape, and we need a lot of energy to do this. So I see there a potential, and I see there the Eco Museum as a sort of strategy, possible strategy of reactivating this action on the landscape through knowledge, because people, and I'm also from Venice, and what Professor Valerani was talking about is a big region where people are really embedded in the landscape, and where the landscape is very fragile and would need a knowledge and would need something to reactivate this closeness, not the oikos. So I think there's really something interesting, and I wanted to hear you on this. Thank you.
Last comment to Giuseppe, then has to go, so...
aiuto, complesso. Giuseppe, inizia tu, poi vado io. Vai un confronto...
Okay, I'll be quick because we are running out of time, but I'm sure we will have opportunities to go deep into your question and your comment with all the webinars, but yes, Ecomuseums Now can be a way for helping people to reacquire knowledge about the place they live, and they reacquire awareness, and they reacquire a sense of place. And that's kind of something that we really need to push on in this phase. I have to say that the CIMETO process had a boost during the pandemic times because a group of people felt the necessity of, during that time where there was social distancing, we couldn't go out, we couldn't reach places, felt the necessity of going back, create connection, and starting a reflection on the importance of this relationship between community and places. So on one side, the pandemic crisis has pushed toward this direction, and ecomuseums could be a way for reframing the way we relate with territory, city, and territory in this new phase. Yeah.
Ma l'unica quello che posso aggiungere è che punterei sulla creatività dei territori, la capacità che hanno i processi partecipativi di reinventare i processi dell'abitare, reinventarli secondo appunto i momenti, e quindi su questo bisogna puntare, sulla possibilità che l'autoriconoscimento dei territori avvenga anche verso nuove pratiche dell'abitare. Quindi ho grande speranza se i processi sono veramente bottom up, e questo lo si può fare sia in contesti rurali, quindi dove lo scambio e la comunicazione è certamente più facile, ma anche in contesti urbani. In grandi città, Barcellona, Milano, io vivo a Milano, faccio il professore a Milano stanno avvenendo dei processi legati ai quartieri, legati alle microeconomie locali, mettendo assieme co-housing, quindi la possibilità di abitare in contesti dove all'interno già dei condomini avvengono degli scambi non soltanto materiali, ma anche culturali. Quindi veramente la creatività locale, secondo me, è veramente l'investimento per la ripartenza.
Grazie.
I wrote a sort of English translation in the chat, so.
Okay, so thank you very much.
Bye a tutti. Ciao. Ciao.
Ciao, ciao.
Ciao, ciao. Grazie.
Ciao.
So, your camera and microphone, Giuseppe. Okay, so we follow here. Thank you for the translation, very fast, Juicy. I don't see now new questions.
There is one, Mina Rad.
Your microphone, please.
I do. Is that right? Yeah. I can say it in French. In English. I'm from Paris, and I'm a filmmaker making a film about a virtual museum. Concerning non-material, like music, like sound, how is the Ecomusée concerning conserving this archive? Because with what is happening in the world, we are going to have to safeguard much more this heritage. And I want to know the planification of this economy concerning conserving the immaterial things and sounds, music, and all these things. Je posais la question en disant que on va de plus en plus vers un monde où il faut conserver l'héritage de Paris. Et quelle est la politique de sauvegarde de ces héritages immatériels comme la musique, comme le son dans les économies?
I think that's a very important point because music helps communities to feel attachment, and they through music, to traditional music, popular music, they, you know, the history is there. For example, in the context we have just seen in the Simeto River Valley, in one municipality, there is a strong tradition of songwriters, popular songwriters, and what we call, I don't know the English for, so someone probably can help me with that, but they are called also cantastorie, so storytellers through the music. And there is a strong tradition of that. In the past, there were few very popular people that have been acknowledged also at the national level, also the maybe at the international level too. One name is Ciccio Busacca, and he was from Paterno, one of the municipalities involved into the Simeto process. So now we are trying with the sons and children and grandsons of Ciccio Busacca of pushing this tradition, of course adapting to new things. So they use the approach and something that comes from the history of songwriters, but they are trying also to adapt to, you know, the new languages of the young people and stuff. And this is very nice when we have done several walking along the river with these people singing these all the new songs in this way. That has been a very touching moment. So yes, music is one of the elements for pushing creativity. As Giuseppe was saying before, it's one important aspect of creativity, of local creativity.
Merci.
Thank you, Gilsey. I don't know if we have questions from the floor. I would like to ask Gilsey to develop an idea. Giuseppe was talking about fracture dans les processus d'identité, the broken off identity. This is a very interesting point that is present in other researches in the Service de Museologie à l'Université de Liège. So I would like you stress a little bit more this idea, how a museum or eco museum to you can work on this question of the broken off identities and how you deal with the population, the community, who are the profile of the people close to your process and the people that maybe you have more difficult to make close to the process.
Yes, so let's start from the profiles. Up to now, we have actively involved about 100 people that are contributing to this phase of design and implementation of the eco-museums. They are students, many students, or young people. They're very attracted from this idea because they feel they can do simple things that can make a difference. We have teachers, because teachers also feel the importance of using this tool for attracting their students. So we are starting collaboration with schools thanks to the active involvement of teachers or retired teachers that after retirement, they are very dedicated to that because they feel they can still contribute. We have few farmers, not many farmers, I have to say. We have the farmers that are more young farmers that are trying to implement a new way of doing agriculture. So not the traditional farmers, they are very far from this process because they have other thoughts, other mindset. It's difficult to involve them really actively. But the young people that now are starting farming with, you know, agroecological principle, they're involved, and they feel this could be a tool for preserving the territory. Otherwise, after the incinerator, we had several other threats on the territory of that type, dumping areas, or other proposals of other incinerators, or other things that can destroy the rural landscape. And for these young farmers that have decided to invest into that territory and to commit themselves toward the new way of doing agriculture, they feel they want to defend their territory, and they feel the Ecomuseum can be a tool for defending the territory. So it's also a matter of that. And then people that are used to be present into environmental associations, many of them are finding Ecomuseum a natural link to what they do inside their association. They link that with this tool, which they feel could be a way for including more people. It's difficult to engage low-income people, of course, and that's a long story, because low-income people sometimes, of course, they will have other necessities, but we are feeling that the importance of opening up this process doesn't have to be a niche, a closed process. It has to be open to as much people as we can, taking into account the necessities of the most fragile ones. But this is something that is coming from the group which is organizing the activities, and we are trying to reach out. So what Giuseppe was telling at the beginning, so that there is this misconnection between people who live their place and the territory. And we have witnessed that, because sometimes when we have done interviews with children at school, involved children at schools, many of them which live close to the river, in municipalities that are close to the river, they sometimes don't even have the awareness that there is a river. And this is with children that happens a lot. This is why we call one project "The River Exists," because many of them, as the river in the municipality, the river doesn't pass through the municipality. It's in the rural area of the municipality, and it is the most important river of Sicily. So for us, it was strange that people living there, young people living there, don't even know of the existence of the river. I don't know if I talk too much probably for the translation, so I'll stop.
Yes, in fact, we don't have time to translate now because we have only 1 minute. So unfortunately, we will not translate now. Sorry for that. For the people, if you want to stay, we can try to do a translate, but I will give some information is important for the next session, and we close. If you really need translation to French, stay, and we try to do later. So we will try to fix for next session this problem of chat, because this made impossible. Megan, the student I asked it to translate, in fact I forgot she could not have access to the chat to put the translation in French as I wanted. Sorry, Megan, I forgot this. So we'll try to fix this for next session, and then all the participants also can put their names to inscribe if we don't see the hands. But for today, I think it worked. But next time we have more time for debate because we have less people talking. So come again. We will fix the problems that we will be in contact with you by email. I put the email of our organization in the chat if you have other questions or if you need contact with the speakers. And I will put now also in the chat the site of our Service de Museologie at the University of Liège. This is our agenda. We will up to date with the flyer of each separated session. Don't forget the link for each session is a different link. So we send always 1 hour before they start. Thank you very much for coming. And thank you, Jules. Thank you, Guido, for all the translations. It's very nice to have young comments because in my experience with eco museums and communitary museums, there's always a problem or a gap between generations. Who created the eco museum? Sometimes when they are not more involved with the process, we don't have new generations to renew the process that needs to be long. So it's very nice to have to see that you are working with people in different generations. Thank you very much. We close for today and we stay here to short translate the translation for the ones need in French. You can stop recording, please, Josie.